Hello, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video, this time with another Moody Forest image, which I want to edit by only using Adobe Lightroom and maybe the Nick Collection plugin as well. So before I start editing, let's first check out the before and after images. Alright, my goal for this image is to have a nice contrast between those dark trees in the foreground and those leaves which get hit by the light from above. Also, I might want to change the green color tones and give them more of a red look. I know I have done this a lot, but I think in this case it just will look good. And I actually want to start by doing this right after activating the lens corrections real quick. Then let's head all the way down to the calibration tab. Now to change those green leaves, I can simply drop the blue primary hue and you can see the leaves getting way more red. I actually want to drop the hues almost all the way down, and then I also want to boost the saturation. I think I just want to go really crazy on this shot. So you might see some strange values like this here, which I normally wouldn't do. So while we're at it, let's also drop the green hue and boost its saturation. Okay. Now if I click on this button, you can see the before and after. And this makes a major difference, as you can see. Alright, but let's head to the global exposure settings for a moment. I think I could drop the exposure some more, because I want to make it look like a really mysterious photo. And so we don't lose any shadows, I want to increase them, actually all the way up. And I also can increase the whites a little bit. Then let's add a little bit of clarity. And I think I also might want to drop the dehaze. This will not only add a nice foggy look to the image, but also brighten the image up a little bit. Especially in those bright areas, this will help for the mood of the image. And then let's see, maybe I want to drop the vibrance a little bit. Okay, now the colors aren't that strong anymore. I think that's better. Of course, I also have a few local adjustments applied. In this case, I have created two radial filters. And this one right here is, of course, for the bright part in the center of the image. And I want to further brighten it up to have some nice contrast going on between bright and dark. So let's increase the exposure first. And I can also add some highlights. And let's see what happens if I turn up the contrast. Okay, I think that looks quite cool. Then let's jump to the second radial filter. This one lies over a rather dark area. I want to change that actually. So first I can of course increase the exposure. I think that looks quite nice, but I want to go on by increase the clarity, which will help with the brightness as well. Then let's also increase the highlights. And finally, I think I want to drop the temperature just a little bit to give this area some more of a blue color tone. Okay, and that's it for the local adjustments already. And of course, I want to do a little bit of color grading. First, I want to brighten up the orange leaves some more. Here I am in the luminance tab, where I just boost the orange luminance. You can see if I go all the way up, those leaves get really bright. So let's go with a lower value, something like this maybe. Okay. And of course, I also want to apply some split toning and just choose a warm color tone for the highlights. Okay, then let's apply some sharpening real quick. And maybe let's also add some vignetting. Alright, this looks already pretty cool, but as said in the intro, I might want to use the Nick Collection plugin. I'm not sure if I want to use it at all, but I want to check it Maybe I can find some nice effects. So I right click on the thumbnail, go to edit in and hit Color Effects Pro 4. And here I want to go with the polarization filter, as this will help making those orange color tones a little bit more interesting. Now, as you can see, when I boost the strength all the way up, those orange leaves will get a little bit brighter and also get some more saturation. But the problem is this blue area in the bottom center part of the image will get darker due to this polarization effect. So I can't really use it this way. Instead, I can add some control points by clicking this button right there. And then let's set the point somewhere around here and increase the size by dragging this slider. And now let's boost the saturation. Okay, and then let's hit save. And at this point, I want to stop the editing, since especially this shot is easily overdone in my opinion. So I hope this was helpful and interesting. Of course, if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.